Hi everybody. I'm going to be reading you another bedtime story out of the Grimm's Complete Fairy Tales book. And I'm not going to try to block out the ambient sounds of pages being turned or anything like that. So I think it gives something, it adds a little something to the story as it's being told, because it really feels like you're being read to. And for some, that triggers those warm childhood memories, so it's comforting. So let's get all tucked up and ready for bed and ready for your bedtime story. I'm going to be reading you Little Red Riding Hood. There once was a sweet little maid, much beloved by everybody, but most of all by her grandmother, who never knew how to make enough of her. Once she sent her a little red riding hood of velvet, and as it was very becoming to her, and she never wore anything else, people called her the Little Red Riding Hood. One day her mother said to her, "Come, Little Red Riding Hood, here are some cakes and a flask of wine for you to take to grandmother. She is weak and ill, and they will do her good. Make haste and start before it grows hot, and walk properly and nicely, and don't run, or you might fall and break the flask of wine, and there will be none left for grandmother. And when you go into her room, don't forget to say good morning instead of staring about you." "I will be sure to take care," said Little Red Riding Hood to her mother, and gave her hand upon it. Now the grandmother lived far away in the wood, half an hour's walk from the village. And when Little Red Riding Hood had reached the wood, she met the wolf. But as she did not know what a bad sort of animal he was, she did not feel frightened. "Good day, Little Red Riding Hood," said he. "Thank you kindly, wolf," she answered. "Where are you going so early, Little Red Riding Hood?" "To my grandmother's." "What are you carrying under your apron?" "Cakes and wine we baked yesterday, and my grandmother is weak and ill, and they will do her good and strengthen her." "Where does your grandmother live, Little Red Riding Hood?" "A quarter of an hour's walk from here. Her house stands beneath the oak trees. You may know it by the hazel bushes," said Little Red Riding Hood. The wolf thought to himself, "That tender young thing would be just a delicious morsel, and would taste even better than the old one. I must somehow manage to get both of them." Then he walked by Little Red Riding Hood a little while and said, "Little Red Riding Hood, just look at the pretty flowers that are growing all around you, and I don't think you're listening to the song of the birds. You are posting along as if you were going to school. And is it so delightful out here in the woods?" Little Red Riding Hood glanced around her, and when she saw the sunbeams darting here and there through the trees and the lovely flowers everywhere, she thought to herself, "If I were to take a fresh nosegay to my grandmother, she would be very pleased, and it is so early in the day that I shall reach her in plenty of time." And so she ran about the woods looking for flowers, and as she picked one, she saw still a prettier one a little farther off, and so she went farther and farther into the woods. But the wolf went straight to grandmother's house and knocked at the door. "Who's there?" cried grandmother. "Little Red Riding Hood," he answered, "and I have brought you some cake and wine. Please open the door." "Lift the hatch," said grandmother. "I'm too feeble to get up." So the wolf lifted the latch, and the door flew open, and he fell on the grandmother and ate her up without saying a word. Then he drew on her clothes, put on her cap, lay down in her bed, and drew the curtains. Little Red Riding Hood was all this time running about among the flowers, and when she had gathered as many as she could hold, she remembered her grandmother and set off to go to her. She was very surprised to find the door standing open when she came to the door. She came inside, and she felt very strange and thought to herself, "Oh dear, how uncomfortable I feel, and I was so glad this morning to go to my grandmother." And when she said, "Good morning," there was no answer. Then she went up to the bed and drew back the curtains, and there lay grandmother with her cap pulled over her eyes so that she looked very odd. "Oh, grandmother, what large ears you have, the better to hear you with." "Oh, grandmother, what great eyes you have, the better to see you with. Oh, grandmother, what large hands you have, the better to take hold of you with. But, grandmother, what a terribly large mouth you have, the better to devour you. And no sooner had the wolf said it than he made one bound from the bed and swallowed up poor little Red Riding Hood. Then the wolf, having satisfied his hunger, lay down again in the bed and went to sleep, and he began to snore loudly. A huntsman who heard as he was passing by and thought, how the old woman snores. I had better see if there's anything the matter with her. Then he went into the room, walked up to the bed, and saw the wolf lying there. At last I find you, you old sinner, he said. I have been looking for you for a long time. And he made up his mind that the wolf had swallowed the grandmother whole, and that she might still be saved. So he did not fire, but he took a pair of shears and began to slit up the wolf's body. When he made a few snips, Little Red Riding Hood appeared, and after a few more snips, she jumped out and cried, "Oh dear, how frightened I have been! It is so dark inside the wolf!" And then out came old grandmother, still living and breathing. But Little Red Riding Hood went and quickly fetched some large stones, and with it she filled up the wolf's body, so that when he waked up and was going to rush away, the stones were so heavy that he sank back down and fell dead. They were all three very pleased. The huntsman took off the wolf's skin and carried it home. The grandmother ate the cakes and drank the wine and held up her head again. And Little Red Riding Hood said to herself that she would never stray about in the woods alone, but would mind her mother and what she told her afterward. It must also be related how a few days afterwards, when Little Red Riding Hood was again taking cakes to her grandmother, another wolf spoke to her and wanted to tempt her to leave the path. But she was on her guard and went straight on her way and told her grandmother how the wolf had met her and he wished her good day. But he had looked so wicked about the eyes that she thought if it had not been on the high road, he would have devoured her. "Come," said the grandmother, "we will shut the door so that he may not get in." Soon afterward, the wolf came knocking at the door and calling out, "Open the door, grandmother. I am Little Red Riding Hood, bringing you cakes." But they remained still and did not open the door. After that, the wolf slunk by the house and got at last upon the roof to wait until Little Red Riding Hood should return home in the evening. Then he meant to spring down upon her and devour her in the darkness. But the grandmother discovered his plot. Now there stood before the house a great stone trough, and the grandmother said to the child, "Little Red Riding Hood, I was boiling sausages yesterday. So take the bucket and carry away the water they were boiled in and pour it into the trough." And Little Red Riding Hood did so until the great trough was quite full. When the smell of sausages reached the nose of the wolf, he snuffled it up and looked around and stretched out his neck so far that he lost his balance and began to slip. And he slipped down off the roof straight into the great trough and was drowned. Then Little Red Riding Hood went home cheerfully and came to no harm. The end.